My 24-year-old female, fiance, 25-year-old male, and I have been together for 4 years now. We got engaged a few months ago, and I'm moving away for work next month. My fiance has a 14-year-old sister who is the youngest of four siblings. Lately, I just find myself so angry at her and everything that I'm contemplating on leaving. We've been together for 4 years, and she used to be the sweetest kid we knew. She loved anything K-pop, so I used to talk to her about that, and I got her light sticks for yearly presents. One day, after a year, she just flipped the switch on us. She became this bitter, passive-aggressive person that acts like a jealous girlfriend whenever I'm around. I invited all the siblings to go shopping. She said no. The next day, as everyone was getting ready to go, she invited herself into my car without saying a word to me or my fiancé. She just went and sat in my car and refused to get off. My fiancé didn't say anything, and we just dealt with it. At the shopping mall, she kept squeezing herself between me and my fiancé whenever we held hands. It was a miracle to hold hands for more than 15 minutes because she kept cutting us off. Whenever he's not looking, she'd position herself between us and push me to the back of the line. My fiancé didn't say anything, and we just dealt with it. I went on a family road trip with my fiancé a few months ago. I couldn't sleep well in moving cars, so I was awake while my fiancé slept. I saw her staring at us the entire time, and she even counted how many times my fiancé was slipping in and out of sleep. How do I know that? Because she told us all, Jay was falling asleep 15 times and awake for 10 minutes. Whenever we sit on a couch, she'd sit on the armrest where my fiancé is instead of another chair. If I ever go to the bathroom, consider my seat permanently gone. He didn't say anything, and we just dealt with it. All the pushing, glaring, stomping, squeezing, cutting, and slamming has been happening continuously for the past 2.5 years, and it's still happening. I did talk to him a lot about how her behaviors remind me of a jealous girlfriend trying to win her man back, and how I'm not okay with these catfights for the past years. He said he spoke to his mom, and they tried to correct her behavior, but the sister just stomped away and slammed her bedroom door. This week, his family planned a trip to Vegas to celebrate his mom, but I decided to stay home because the last time we went on a trip, I got so upset about no one doing anything about the sister's behavior, and I kept feeling like I got stepped on. I thought staying home this time would be the solution, but now that I'm alone, I kept thinking, do I want this for the rest of my life? I love the guy, I do, but I'm so furious about always getting the short end of the stick. Either I get disrespected to my face and no one does anything because everyone is afraid of her tantrums, or I get left out. All I know is this isn't the family dynamic I'd want for my future if I marry this guy. They said she can't change who she is. I agree. But I also argue that they can at least teach her not to treat me like I'm the other woman, especially not after I helped his family buy a new car or just stop pushing me. Now I'm just so frustrated. I don't know if I want to transfer the title of the car over to his family, knowing that she wasn't corrected from pushing me. I knew I couldn't change her and she wasn't the one I'm marrying, so I just stayed away from her. Now I'm thinking, is this going to be for the rest of my life? Just staying home, staying out. If I show up, I get pushed. My fiance's brother said that he never bothered bringing his girlfriend home because of this sister. Then why do I have to deal with it? After helping them purchase a car, is it even worth it? Maybe I'm hormonal. I just feel so angry. After my significant other comes back from this family trip that I'm left out of, they're going to ask me to take time off my day to go to DMV to transfer title for the car. Is staying with this family even worth it? I'm moving away internationally in 3 weeks. What do I even do with this car I stupidly purchased? Whenever I voice my frustration, all I get is, yeah, she's a BF her. You're better, baby. I love you. And nothing is ever done about it. All I know is I don't want to be treated like the other woman for the rest of my life if I marry into this family. Edit for info. First of all, thank you all for messaging and commenting. I read through all the comments and saw you guys asking if I ever called her out in public. The answer is yes. When the shopping incident happened, and she refused to get out of my car, My SO told her out loud in front of all the siblings to behave if she's coming, otherwise she can't join us again. She didn't respond at all and just went on her phone. Thinking back, I'm pretty sure her pushing me to the back of the line at the mall was her retaliating. She only stopped when my SO turned around. She'd never do it in front of him. We stopped hanging out with her without her parents present again. That was when I told him to tell his mom to help. We're not her parents, and it can't go on like this. He did tell his mom, and I did hear the mom correcting her. What happened next was her acting super friendly when mom is around, then went back to disrespecting when mom is out of the room. She went as far as putting her hand on my shoulders in front of mom. I was so surprised I flinched at her touch. After mom went in, she reverted back to pushing and cutting between us. I can see now the problem is my SO not setting boundaries for so long that my frustration is deep-rooted. Usually I'm not so unreasonable that staying home from a trip makes me write a long Reddit post, but they all knew I was moving, and time is just more important to me now, so I'll find better ways to spend it. As for the car, it was an agreement that I purchase my company car for the family and they pay me back. As mad as I am, it was an agreement. The car just shows me that no matter how much I do for the family, maybe this is the best they could be. Now, for a few comments before the update. Comment 1. Not the idiot if you bought the car yourself for them. Take the car back and try to sell it and tell your fiancé, either him and his family start treating you like a human, or you are done. The fact everyone is okay with you missing a trip due to her antics is kinda appalling when you just helped buy them a car. You deserve decency from that family. You shouldn't beg for them to stop the child from openly being hostile with you. Comment 2. First, don't dare give them that car. They can afford vacations. They can afford a car. They won't do anything about her. Maybe she will be one who outgrows this type of childish behavior, or maybe she's the type that's just going to continue to get worse. You don't know, but you do know they won't do anything to actually help themselves. So you could stay, and she can change, or you can stay, and she never does. Now for the update. Hey Reddit, it's been 3 months since my last post, and wow, a lot has happened. I'm back with an update, and let me tell you, it's been a busy ride. So, after I decided to skip the Vegas trip, things got even more intense. My fiancé came back, and the first thing he did was apologize for his sister's behavior. He said he noticed how much it was affecting me, especially with the car situation. He promised we'd go to the DMV together to transfer the title, and he'd make sure his sister wouldn't be an issue anymore. But then, just a week later, his sister did something that made my jaw drop. She actually apologized to me. I was shocked. She came up to me, tears in her eyes, and said she was sorry for how she'd been acting. She admitted she was scared of losing her brother to me and didn't know how to deal with those feelings. I was floored. I mean, I knew she had issues, but I never expected her to own up to them. We had a long talk, just the two of us. She told me about how she felt left out when her other siblings started their own lives, and she was afraid I was going to take her brother away too. I told her about my own fears of joining their family with all the tension. It was a real heart-to-heart, and it felt like we finally understood each other. Things started to change after that. My fiancé and I set some serious boundaries with his sister. He made it clear that while he loved her, he wouldn't tolerate any more disrespect towards me. And you know what? She actually listened. She's been trying really hard to be better, and it's like she's a different person now. But the real test came when we all went on a family outing to the zoo. I was nervous, but it turned out to be a great day. His sister didn't try to squeeze between us or push me away. She even took pictures of me and my fiancé together, which was a huge step for her. And remember the car I helped them buy? Well, we finally went to the DMV, and the title transfer went smoothly. His family started paying me back for the car, just like we agreed. It felt good to see them keeping their word. Now, I'm not saying everything is perfect. There are still moments when his sister slips up, but now she apologizes right away. And my fiancé is always there to support me. It's like we're all learning and growing together. As for me, I did move away for work. It was hard to leave, but my fiancé and I are doing the long-distance thing. We're planning our wedding, and his sister is actually helping with some of the arrangements. Can you believe it? She's even excited about being a bridesmaid. My fiancé's brother, the one who never brought his girlfriend home because of the sister, he's been bringing her around more too. It's like the whole family dynamic is changing, and it's all for the better. X laughed at my parenting, so I cut him off. He favored our daughter, but my son's smile revealed the truth. I had my son when I was young. I was 18, a senior in high school. I was 9 months pregnant when I graduated. I still went to college online, and I worked full-time from home to support myself and my child. I had an apartment by the time I was 19. Now, when my son was 2 months old, I started dating a friend of mine. He quickly took on the role of dad, which was easy for him to do, considering there was no other father figure involved. The guy knows he has a kid, but told the judge he didn't want to meet him, and so he just pays child support. We are now 22, and things have been great. We were actually supposed to get married in December. He had such a good relationship with my son, and honestly, I'm pretty sure my son favored dad over me. But I gave birth to our daughter last month. She was planned. I never thought for a minute he would treat my son differently because he's always been dad. He wanted to be called dad, so he pushed for it. When I was in the hospital after giving birth, he and his parents were hovering over my son and kept telling him to not touch the baby like that, and just kept repeatedly saying stop or don't touch the baby whenever my son tried holding his sister. And since bringing her home, he has been acting weird. He doesn't want me doing basically anything. He picks out all the outfits, he does every feeding, he changes all her diapers. Every time I try to step in, I'm met with a no, I'm going to do it. He has let my son do one feeding, and even then, he was being a helicopter parent about it and telling him he's doing it wrong, and ended up taking the bottle and doing it himself. He even took my daughter to his mom's for a week and gave me no say in it. So I talked to him about it and said he was royally messing with my mental state because he's refusing to let me or my son bond with the baby. And somehow this got on the topic of my son being pushed to the side, and he goes, I don't know how you can expect me to love him like he's my own when I have my own kid now. I'm still his dad, but it's not the same. I want to bond with my daughter. You had your turn, and now it's mine. And like, it was a slap in the face. I kicked him out. I started breastfeeding my daughter, which is something he wouldn't let me do before, but he made me pump because our daughter preferred breast milk. I started trying to bond with my daughter, but like, I just had to check myself into extensive therapy because he cut me and my son out so much that my daughter doesn't feel like my daughter at all. I'm disconnected, like I'm a babysitter or something. Well, he's been begging to come back, and I outright refuse. I hate him. I never thought I'd say that, but I absolutely hate him. He says I'm being ridiculous over him just wanting to bond with his baby, and most women would love to have the dad step in like him. But all that aside, I can't get over what he said about not loving my son as much as his daughter because he raised my son as his own. So I told him that, and he's saying I took it out of context and blew it up. I really don't understand what you guys are on about with him apparently not treating me and my son differently. He literally doesn't let us near my baby. I held my daughter a total of maybe 5 times since I gave birth because he refused to let me do anything, saying that it was his turn and that I had my turn because I carried her for 9 months. He doesn't do anything with my son now either, at all. He also won't let my son near the baby because he's going to hurt her. When he allowed my son to feed my daughter that partial bottle, he was holding our daughter and holding my son's hand at the same time and not letting him do anything, and then told him to go away because he was doing it wrong. He literally took my daughter out of this house for a week, and I didn't even know until his mother was picking them up. And he told me to deal with it because it's his kid too, and his family should be able to spend one-on-one time with her. Like, how is that not him treating us differently? I'm not keeping him from his kid either. I don't know why y'all are jumping to that BS. He also quit his job to be a stay-at-home dad without even telling me. So no, I have an income, never stopped working because I work from home, and a place that's mine. ETA. Thank you, everyone. I think I'm going to log off for a while. I'm just really lost right now. I appreciate all of you. Now for a few comments before the update. Comment 1, not the idiot. What kind of father takes an infant away from a mother who just gave birth? Not to mention forbidding you to breastfeed. What in the actual frick? Your hormones are raging, and he's denying you bonding when it is most important. I wouldn't want a man in my child's life who felt it was acceptable to play house with one kid, then toss them aside because they got a new one. Your son is what, 3 to 4 years old? The son is confused at the cold shoulder from dad, that prevented from bonding with his sibling, and also likely dealing with some displacement issues due to the addition of the new sibling. No, hell no. Comment 2, not the idiot. Not allowing you to have a relationship with your newborn daughter is psycho behavior, and the writing is on the wall that he wants to relegate your son to second-class status in his own home. I'm sorry that you're going through this, but you aren't crazy at all. All these weirdos in the comments who think it's perfectly normal to not love stepchildren as much as biological children are a few years away from being the subjects of their own stepkids and all. Am I the idiot posts about mistreating them? I have no doubt. Now, for the update. Hey everyone, thanks for all the comments and support on my last post. It's been a wild few months, and I've got quite the update for you all. So, after I kicked him out, things got even more intense. He started showing up at my apartment unannounced, trying to see our daughter. I had to get a restraining order because he wouldn't take no for an answer. It was a nightmare, but it gave me some peace of mind knowing he couldn't just barge in whenever he wanted. Now, remember how he quit his job to be a stay-at-home dad? Well, turns out he had been planning this for months. He had saved up a bunch of money without telling me, and he was using it to fight me for custody. He claimed that since I was working full-time and he was the primary caregiver, he should have our daughter. It was a low blow, especially since he had forced that situation by not letting me care for her. The court battle was brutal. He dragged my name through the mud, saying I was an unfit mother because I was always working and not bonding with our daughter. It was ridiculous because he was the one who had pushed me out of her life. But the real shocker came when his mom testified. She said that he had always been resentful of my son because he wasn't his biological child. She claimed he felt trapped into playing dad and that he never really wanted that role. It was a complete 180 from the man I thought I knew. But here's where it gets even crazier. During one of the court sessions, his lawyer slipped up and mentioned a private investigator. I was confused until I got my hands on the report. He had hired someone to follow me around, trying to dig up dirt. The PI found nothing, of course, because I wasn't doing anything wrong. But the fact that he went to that length was chilling. The court eventually ruled in my favor, thank goodness. They saw through his lies and realized that he was trying to manipulate the situation. I was awarded full custody of our daughter, and he got supervised visitation rights. It was a huge relief, but the damage was done. My son was heartbroken over the whole ordeal. He couldn't understand why the man he called dad didn't want him anymore. I've been focusing on rebuilding our little family. My son is in therapy, and it's helping him process everything. He's slowly getting back to his old self, the happy kid he was before all this happened. And my daughter, she's growing so fast. I'm finally getting to bond with her, and it's been amazing. Breastfeeding has been our special time, and I cherish every moment. As for my ex, he's been sticking to the visitation schedule, but it's clear he's not happy about it. He still tries to control things, telling me how to raise our daughter during his visits. But I'm standing my ground. I won't let him push me around anymore. And just when I thought things couldn't get more complicated, I found out why he was so obsessed with our daughter. A mutual friend let it slip that he had always wanted a daughter. He had this idealized vision of being a father to a little girl. And when our daughter was born, he became fixated on making that fantasy a reality. It explained a lot, but it didn't excuse his behavior. My sister's lies blew up when her ex returned with proof. She played the victim, but the house erupted, and I just smirked, knowing the truth would. I, 17-year-old female, live with my mother, my 29-year-old sister, and my 5-year-old niece. I'm autistic and really sensitive to noise. Baby cries are among the worst. When my niece was born, she had colic, and it was the worst experience of my life. Her nursery was right next to my room, and our walls are thin, so I never slept. The nursery and my room are both in the basement while my mom and sister are upstairs, so I was the one dealing with it when the baby woke up a lot of the time. I had a lot of meltdowns over this. It completely wrecked my performance in school. It sounds stupid, but I genuinely became suicidal. The constant noise, being expected to care for the baby when my sister couldn't, the sleep deprivation, all felt like a hell that would never end. The colic lasted 4 months, but even after that, I really struggled. My niece yells all the time when she's playing. Her idea of fun is just making screeching noises all the time. As soon as she realized it upset me, she'd do it intentionally in my ear, especially on car rides, until I'm sobbing. It drives me insane. If my niece is home, there is constant noise. My mother and sister are able to tune out noise, but I can't. If I can hear something, it's like I can't focus on anything else. To be clear, I understand that none of this is my niece's or sister's fault, and it's not anyone's responsibility other than my own. I'm just trying to paint an idea of why this is so overwhelming for me. I don't dislike kids. Living with them is just a lot for me. Yesterday, I learned that my sister is over 6 months pregnant, and they've known for 4 months. I'd noticed her stomach was larger, but my sister is pretty overweight, so I never really became suspicious until very recently. They told me that they were planning on keeping it from me for as long as possible until I noticed, which really terrified me. I really wish I got more time to prepare for this. I'm terrified to do this semester of school, knowing that by the end, I'll be living with a baby again. I don't expect my sister to not have another baby or anything. I just feel really hurt and betrayed that they were planning to hide it for as long as possible. I know I'm not owed this information. It just feels like courtesy, considering we're living together. I've been considering moving to my dad's in another state, but he lives with my brother, who was hurtful towards me, and it seems like an awful idea anyways because I'm going into the last semester of my senior year of high school. I mentioned that I wish they told me sooner, and my sister got upset at me because I'm a child who doesn't need to know all of my business. Am I the jerk? Now, for a few comments before the update, comment 1, not the idiot. Call your dad and explain the situation to him, that you don't want to change schools before the end of your senior year, but that you don't feel safe living with either of them because neither household can give you a safe place. Your sound sensitivity is really valid. This is totally normal with folks on the autism spectrum. And at the same time, you shouldn't be expected to live with someone who abused you, your brother. Tell him that you would like to make plans to be out of the house as soon as you graduate and would like help sorting out a plan. Meanwhile, do you plan on going to college? Are you able to live independently? Do you have a social worker or guidance counselor you can speak with? Someone has to be able to help you make a plan to get out of there. Comment 2, not the idiot. If you can switch rooms with your sister. If not, refuse to do any help with the baby. Your focus needs to be school. You didn't get knocked up, your sister did, and it's your sister and baby daddy's issue. If she just lets the baby cry, take the baby to her room and wake your sister up to be a parent. Also, try and soundproof the wall. Layered carpets, noise-canceling foam, headphones, earplugs, white noise machines. I'm sorry you can't move in with your dad instead, but the end is in sight for when you go to college. Now for the update. Hey everyone, thanks for all the comments on my last post. I wanted to give you an update on what's been happening since I found out about my sister's pregnancy. It's been a month since I learned about my sister being pregnant again, and let me tell you, things have been intense. I thought I had my hands full before, but this past month has been a whole new level of chaos. First off, my sister's pregnancy has been way more complicated than the last one. She's been on bed rest for the past 2 weeks, which means she can't do much around the house or take care of my niece as much as she used to. That's put a lot more pressure on my mom and me. My mom has been working extra shifts to cover the medical bills, So guess who's been picking up the slack? Yep, me. I've been trying to juggle schoolwork and taking care of my niece, which has been a nightmare. Remember how I mentioned my niece loves to make screeching noises? Well, it's gotten worse. She's figured out that when she screams, she gets my attention, even if it's negative. So now it's like she's testing me, seeing how far she can push before I have a meltdown. But here's the jaw-dropping part. My sister's husband, who's been out of the picture for a while, suddenly showed up out of nowhere. Turns out he wants to be involved with the new baby. This was a huge surprise because he hasn't been around since my niece was a baby. His sudden return caused a massive argument between him and my sister, which I could hear through the thin basement walls. It was like living in the middle of a soap opera. During one of their fights, my sister blurted out that she wasn't even sure if the baby was his. That revelation was like a bomb going off in our house. My mom got involved, and there were tears and shouting that lasted for hours. I tried to stay out of it, but it was impossible with the noise and the tension. In the midst of all this, I've been trying to figure out my own plans. Moving to my dad's is still off the table because of my brother, but I've been looking into other options. Maybe staying with a friend, or finding a part-time job to save up for my own place. Just when I thought things couldn't get more complicated, my sister had another surprise for me. She sat me down and apologized for not telling me about the pregnancy sooner. She explained that she was scared of how I'd react and didn't want to stress me out during my final semester. I was still hurt, but I could see she was genuinely sorry. Now, here's where the misunderstanding comes in. Last week, I overheard my sister talking on the phone about getting rid of the problem. I panicked, thinking she was considering something drastic because of the stress. I confronted her and we had a huge fight. I was so upset, thinking she was talking about the baby. But it turns out she was talking about her car. It's been breaking down a lot, and she was venting to a friend about wanting to sell it. I felt so embarrassed for jumping to conclusions and causing a scene over a misunderstanding. If you like this video, you'll probably like these too. Also, while you're here, please consider subscribing. It's your support that keeps this channel alive and allows me to make better and longer videos. Have a great day.